Hello everyone. So in this video lecture, I'm going to explain you jQuery. Okay. So I will upload two or more videos related to jQuery. Okay. So in this first video lecture, I will explain you basic theory, or I can say introductory type of this session is. Okay. So let's start. Okay. First of all, jQuery introduction. jQuery is a lightweight, write less and do more JavaScript library. Okay, so basically jQuery is JavaScript library. The purpose of jQuery is to make it much easier to use JavaScript on your website. And we all know that JavaScript, which is used to make our website very interactive. Okay, it takes a lot of common tasks that require many lines of JavaScript code to accomplish and wrap them into method that you can call with a single line of code. jQuery also simplify a lot of complication things from JavaScript, like AJAX call and DOM manipulation. DOM manipulation, you can check my video, okay, or in that session related to document object model, I have explained how to manipulate this particular DOM object. Now, jQuery library contain this all the things, okay. So first one is HTML DOM manipulation. You can also do CSS manipulation, HTML event methods, effects and animations, okay. And last and important one is AJAX, okay. What you should know already before jumping into jQuery, okay. So first one is HTML, after that CSS, and after that JavaScript, okay. Not highly intense knowledge, but you should have a basic knowledge. After that, adding jQuery to your web page. Now if I say I want to use jQuery, okay, so first step is to download jQuery, okay. So there are several ways to start using jQuery on your website. So you can download the jQuery library from jQuery.com, which is official site from where you can download jQuery library, okay. And include jQuery from CDN like Google. Now CDN, that means content delivery network. So in that case, Google will provide you this jQuery formation, okay. And you just need to include link of that particular jQuery that is provided by Google. And in remaining case, that means you have to download that particular library file and you have to include in your project. Downloading jQuery, there are two versions of jQuery, okay. So first one is production version. This is for your live website because it has been magnified and compressed, okay. And the second one is a development version, which is used for testing and development, and uncompressed and readable code. So this both version you can download from jQuery.com. After that, let's see jQuery syntax. So let's see, basic syntax is like that is, okay. So over here the first part is a dollar, okay, and after that in parentheses you specified selector. Okay, so is this selector means CSS wala selector? Yes, actually yes. Okay, so is this selector, that means you can it is very similar to like CSS selector. Okay, after that, using dot operator, we have called we can call any function. Okay, for example, dot click, dot double click, like that. After that, now over here, this sign. Okay, this dollar sign, this define jQuery, okay. And after that, over here you can see this selector, which is any HTML selectors, okay. After that, this action, which is action to be performed on particular element, okay. So what you have to define is, first one is this dollar sign to represent that you are defining jQuery, okay. And the second one is your selector, and third one is your action. So three things you have to remember while defining jQuery. Now over here, these are some examples, okay. Over here you can see, okay, this dollar sign to represent jQuery, this in parenthesis dot hide. So what does it mean? It hide the current element, okay. So this, that means whatever a current element it is, okay. Sorry. So you can call it. After that, over here you can see this over here it is element selector. Okay, so in a double quotation I have just specified P. So what does it mean? It hides all the P elements. After that, this one, it is your, it hide all the elements with class is equals to test, because over here we have specified dot test, and dot operator that we use generally in CSS to represent your class attribute, okay, in HTML. After that, similar, it is ID, okay, it hide all the element with ID is equals to test. Now, jQuery selectors, okay, this selector elements based on the element name, okay, as explained in previous slide, but it is kind of some with some more detail. Now over here you can see, now just read this function, okay, just read this function, it is dollar, after that selector, and this is method, okay. So what happened whenever your document dot ready, so what does it mean? Whenever your document is ready, okay, so this ready function will only call when your document is loaded fully, okay. So after that ready function will be called. Now inside this ready function you can see over here another function is defined, okay. Which one function? Over here you have call particular methods on particular element, okay. For example, over here this is button, this is element selector, okay, button dot click. So this function is called, and inside this function over here you can see this is element selector of p tag, okay, and p dot hide. So what does it mean? Whenever document is ready, this function should be called, okay. And what will this function will execute? Whenever button is clicked, okay, and then whenever this button is clicked, this paragraph will be hide. So this is the meaning of this jQuery statement, okay. Now in similar manner you can define function for ID selector and class selector. Over here we have used element selector, okay, so you can also use this particular syntax for ID selector and class selector. jQuery event methods, okay. Now all the different visitors action that a web page can respond to are all called as events, okay. An event represent the precise moment when something happens. For example, if I'm clicking on particular button, if I am mouse overing to the particular paragraph, okay, if I am double clicking on something, if I am click on image, if I select the tag, just like that. Okay, over here these are some example, like a moving mouse over in element, selecting radio button, clicking on an element, okay. So these are the example of event. jQuery syntax for event methods, okay. So to assign a click event to all the paragraph on a page, so how you can do this? For example, it's your task to assign a click event to all the paragraph on a page. So let's see, how can we define a click event to all the paragraph on a page? Okay, simple, in using dollar in parenthesis you have to specify p, that means all the paragraphs. Over here you are selecting element selector, okay, and you want to implement click event, so you just need to define dot click, which is a function. The next step is to define what should happen when the event fires, okay. So you must pass function to the event. So over here you can see in this particular event we have passed one function. So what does it mean? Whenever user click on particular paragraph, something has to happen, okay. So what happened? This goes inside this function. Over here you can see this is okay, this click, or this is my round parenthesis. Over here in round parenthesis I have defined one function, okay. So whenever this click happens, this function will automatically be called, okay. And whatever you want to apply, for example, whenever a particular paragraph is clicked, you want to put some alert message or kind of anything, you can do it, okay. After that, commonly used jQuery event methods. So first one is, as we have seen, document dot ready, okay. This method allows us to execute a function when document is fully loaded, and one important thing is it is very essential, because it sometimes happen that your page is not even fully loaded and your jQuery is performed. Okay, so it will kind of a mess something. So this condition is required. These functions should only be called once your document is fully loaded. After that, click when user click on HTML element, double click. Okay, so DBL. Double click, user double clicks on particular HTML element. Okay, so this is the functions and its description whenever mouse enter. Okay, this is one function, mouse enters. So this particular function, when happens, function call mouse enters. So this is whenever mouse pointer enters to the particular HTML element. And exact opposite to this, mouse pointer leaves the HTML element, then you can apply mouse leave function. After that, over. Okay, so it is a combination of a mouse enter and mouse leave method. After that, focus. A form field get focus. Whenever you are filling form, for example, write enter your name. Okay, so whenever you are whenever you just click on particular field, particular input field, then it gets focus. Okay, so you can apply customize. Okay, for example, background color should be changed, so you can do it using focus method. After that, blur. When form field loses focus, for example, I have entered my name. Okay, now I'm jumping to my mobile number. Okay, so name loses its focus. Okay, that means at that time blur function will be called. After that, on. This function attach one or more events handler for selected item. So using this method you can apply one or more functions. Okay, so this is just a basic idea of a jQuery. Okay, and must watch my next video, which will explain practically how to use jQuery. Okay, so I hope you have enjoyed. Okay, so thanks for listening. Bye bye.